Hello and welcome to Micah Tutorials. In this tutorial, we are going to discuss the immutability of string objects. First, we will see what does this immutability means, that is how string objects are immutable, and then we will see why they are immutable. In Java, string objects are immutable, which means that they are unmodifiable or unchangeable. Once a string object is created, its data or state can't be changed. Whenever we apply any operation on a string object, a new string object is created as a result of the operation, but the original string is never changed. Let's take an example. Suppose if we create a string object with the content Mahika, and then if we call concat method for that object, the job of this concat method is to append the string at the end. That is, it performs concatenation. So what we want this tutorials to be appended at the end of this string Mahika. So we are saying str.concat and we are passing tutorial as tutorials as parameter. So now when we will try to print the value of str thereafter, it will print Mahika only, it will not print Mahika tutorials, and the reason for that is this str is a string object and it is unmodifiable or immutable. We can understand it in a better way by looking at this pictorial representation. What we did, we created first a string object with the literal mechanism and the content was Mahika. So this would happen. A reference variable str will be created in stack, and then this Mahika object will be created in SCP. Since we are using literal mechanism, this string object will be placed in SCP, and then this str will refer to this Mahika object, which is in SCP. And then when we call concat method, we are trying to append tutorials to this str. So in this case, str.concat tutorials, this statement will lead to the concatenation of tutorials with Mahika, but in that case a new object will be created. Like here we can see that str is referring to this Mahika object, but when we want the concatenation of tutorials, when we say str.concat tutorials, so this statements lead to the creation of a new object with the resultant value Mahika tutorials. But str is still referring to this Mahika, and that's the reason why if we try to print the value of str even after the concat method has been called, we get the Mahika as output. So since string objects are immutable, what this method really do, it creates and return a new string that contains the result of the operation. If we want that when we print the str, we should get the value Mahika tutorials rather than Mahika, then what we need to do is, we need to store the result of this method call in the reference variable str. So now in that case, what will happen? Again, str.concat tutorials will of course create a new object with the resultant value, that is Mahika tutorial, and then we are changing the reference of str to the result of this operation. So now str will refer to this newly created string, which is the result of concatenation. So now if we will try to print str, we will get Mahika tutorials rather than Mahika, because we have explicitly changed the reference of str. So this is how string objects are immutable. That is, whenever you will apply any operation on string object, a new object will be created with the resultant value. Original object will never be changed. So we have seen that string objects are immutable. Now next we will see why these string objects are immutable. There are a number of reasons for why string objects are immutable in Java. We are going to discuss some of them. The very first reason is The requirement of string constant pool. We know that whenever we create string objects using literal mechanism, in that case JVM first searches SCP. If object is already there, then no new object is created, only a reference is created and it start referring to the object which was already present in SCP. Let's take an example. Suppose if we created str1 with hello, then in that SCP will be searched for hello. If it is not there when you are creating it for the first time, one object will be created and placed in SCP and str1 will start referring to that. And if later on we say str2 equals hello, in that case again JVM will first search SCP. Since hello object is already present there, no new object will be created, only a reference will be created with str2. So both str1 and str2 refer to the same object hello. Now if string were mutable, then changing the string with one reference will lead to the wrong value for other references as well. Suppose if we change the object from hello to welcome for str1, then str2 will also get the value welcome because both are referring to same memory location. So to make this string constant pool work in correct manner, strings are immutable. That is, since multiple reference variable can refer to the same object, these are immutable. Whenever if you will apply any operation, a new resultant string object will be created, but original will not be changed because other reference variable might also be referring to the same object. So this is one of the reason why string is immutable in Java. Now second reason is security. String is widely used as parameter for many Java classes. Like for reading files in Java, we can pass the path of the files and directories as string. Similarly, for opening database connection, we can pass database URL as string. In case if strings were not immutable, this would have led to serious security threats. Like someone could access any file for which he has authorization and then he could change the file name either deliberately or accidentally and can gain access to some other file which could cause serious security issues. So for these reasons again string is immutable. Similarly, when we are connecting to database or any other machine in network, mutating string value can again cause security threats. And another reason is that as the parameters are string in reflection, mutable strings could cause security threat in reflection too. And string is heavily used in class loading mechanism also. So for all these reasons, again string object has to be immutable. Next, immutable objects are naturally thread safe. Since immutable objects cannot be changed, they can be shared among multiple threads freely. This eliminates the requirement of doing synchronization. And another reason for having string objects as immutable is caching of hash codes. The hash code of a string is frequently used in Java. For example, in a hash map or in hash set. Being immutable guarantees that hash code will always be the same so that it can be cached without worrying about the changes. That means there is no need to calculate hash code every time it is used. So this is more efficient. So for all these reasons, string objects are immutable in Java. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please subscribe the channel if you have not subscribed it yet.